Hey everybody, it's Michelle with Florida Keys Birding and Butterfly Garden, and the video today is on the Gulf Fritillary. So this butterfly is identified by its orange wings and black markings, white spots, and a chain-like border on its hind wings. Below it has a brown with elongated silvery spots, and the male and the female both look similar, except the female is a little bit more pale. Gulf fritillaries have chemical defense mechanisms in which they release odorous chemicals in the response to predator sightings. As a result, common predators learn to avoid the species. Pheromones play a critical role in male-female courtships, with male gulf fritillaries emitting sex hormones that contribute to mate choices in females. Along with chemical pheromones, the presence of nuptial gifts plays an important role in the mating and courtship process. So during the physical act of copulation, males transfer nutrients materials to the females. These extra nutrients given to the females can be used by a female to her advantage during the process of oogenesis. The use of nuptial gifts in the mating process, especially when females mate with multiple males, relates to the idea of female choice in deciding egg fertilization. That's also interesting. So eggs are a yellow color when laid on host plants and their leaves. The egg stage is 4 to 8 days. The caterpillar larval stage is 2 to 3 weeks. The chrysalis pupal stage is 5 to 10 days, and the adult butterfly stage is 2 to 4 weeks. It's pretty interesting that they don't live very long, you know? I thought it was. It's like you see the butterflies and you think it's the same one coming to see you every day, but it's probably actually not, since they only live a couple of weeks at a time. Larva is orange with greenish black stripes and black spines. The host plant for this butterfly is passion flower, species including maypop, corky stem, and yellow passion flower. Any kind of passion vine generally will do. They will do multiple broods in the breeding season, mostly in summertime, but they will lay eggs in the fall as well, at least here in the Keys where it's still hot all the time. They feed on nectar from flowers such as native salvias or sage, bee balm, tithonia, asters, lantana, and zinnias. So if you put these in your garden along with some passion vine, you're gonna get gulf fritillaries if that's what you're trying to attract. I get quite a few each day to my garden in the morning time. I have a corky stem actually that grows wild through my citrus tree, so they come to my citrus tree and they lay eggs on the passion vine, and then I have a passion vine corky stem and a regular passion flower vine in another area that they'll lay eggs on as well, so they come often to visit, and they're particularly abundant in the fall, and they're pretty common, at least here in Florida they are. So this butterfly often visits gardens. During the fall, these butterflies migrate to the southern portions of the state, which is here, can be generally found year-round in South Florida. Like I had said before, that's correct. Definitely my observations would say so. So it is a part of the brushfoot longwing butterfly family. So these are a few facts about the Gulf fritillary. I hope you learned more about the Gulf Fritillary. Fritillary, that'd be funny because that means that it kind of flits all over the place. But yeah, I thought that would be interesting. It'd be funny if it was named that. So I hope you learned a little bit more about this one. I hope you get one to your garden. And please don't forget to like and subscribe this video if you liked it and you learned something. And let me know if you see these in your backyard butterfly garden. Thanks again. Bye.